Sure. War Eagle, everybody. We're excited to get this 2018 season kicked off. You know, we started this second semester January the 10th, and we've been practicing. Now we've got 11 squad games in, and we open up and host Longwood University out of Virginia this Friday at 5. Saturday game time is at 1 o'clock, and Sunday is at 1 o'clock. And, you know, it's been interesting with three new coaches, you know, having those guys get acclimated and getting settled and get connected with us. Also, you know, we have 17 returning baseball players, but 17 new players. So there's a lot of newness. There's a lot of excitement about the known and the unknown with our roster. But we've gotten down to these last, 48 hours before we get to go compete. And definitely have somebody to my left and right with Dylan Ingram, our senior first baseman, and Casey Mize, our junior right-handed pitcher that'll get the ball game one. Two guys I believe in to help me that has been here with me, last year to help lead us to get this 2018 season started off. Yeah, what I know is we'll see a left-handed pitcher, what's his name, Farkas, Friday, and we'll see a right-handed starter that Longwood announced, Boyston. So I think we have more options. I think we have more depth this year than we've had. Of course, Casey gets the ball game one. Davis Daniel had a great bullpen for us today, so we'll pencil him in at Saturday, and then I think both clubs are saying we're TBA. Which somebody said to me a while ago, you know, does TB stand for Tanner Burns? So that might happen, but, you know, we'll respect the game. We're asking Casey to probably give us maybe not innings or a certain number of pitches, but he's probably trained for 70, 75 pitches, maybe 4 or 5 innings. I think the last outing he went 4 innings in a squad game. So I mentioned that by saying that, you know, we might have to cover 8 or 9 innings the first 2 ball games out of the bullpen. So we want to make sure that we stay strong in our bullpen. A lot of guys don't get opportunities. So I would think over half the game or over half the game is going to be covered by our bullpen the first 2 days. So we want to wait before we announce a starter to see how things shake out. It looks like if everything holds the same, we'll start Brett Wright at catcher. But also, as we go through the weekend, Stephen Williams, I'd love to get a start, the freshman from Albany, Georgia. Dylan at first base, we've still got another practice to go through and make sure everybody comes out of it healthy and not banged up. But Dylan Ingram, Brendan Venter, our guys, we'd love to get both their bats in the lineup. But I'm excited to have my senior out on the field to get me started off. Luke Jarvis at second base, you know, that's how we ended the season. Just love Luke being at second base. I feel like he's a really good shortstop, and I think he has a chance to be a dynamic second baseman. And that gives the opportunity for sophomore Will Holland, if he can dominate the routine play like I know he can, to get an opportunity to, you know, play shortstop every day. You know, still, he got so much experience last year. Will, he started 41 ball games and appeared in 45, so I think he's ready. And we've all of our preseason work, we've given him the lion's share of reps at shortstop. Josh Anthony, of course, I thought that was some of the best third base play. This will be my 17th consecutive year to be lucky enough to coach in the SEC, and I thought his defensive play at third base was tops at that position since I've been in the league. And Brendan Venter is one of those swing guys. He's been swinging it really well the last 2 weeks, and we got to keep finding a place for him to get in the lineup. He's had most of the reps or shared the reps with Josh. Because when we practice, you know, we don't play any outside competition. Our whole fall and all this leading up to we play another opponent, we don't get to play outside competition. So we're always playing two teams. And so a lot of these reps are shared equally. So that's a known commodity on the infield with Josh, with Will, with Jarvis, with Dylan. I mean, these guys have played in our program and played in big games and won big games and had success and are a year older, and I'm excited to see them, you know, compete. Casey and Davis Daniel are known commodities in this 1-2 hole starting pitchers. Brett Wright, Stephen Williams are exciting, but they're unknown. And that, I would just lead into outfield with saying the same thing. Jay Estes, since we came back in August, is basically, he's taken some ground balls on the infield recently, just for a coaching staff to be prepared if you have to make some adjustments or somebody goes down. But really, from day one, we've played him in center field and feel like that's went really well. I'm excited to see Jay because he's never off of a fastball. We think he does something offensively for us. And, you know, center field has been these last 2 years I've been scared to death about replacing center field. You had Anthony Greer 2 years ago, and it's the first pick of the Arizona Diamondbacks, and how do you replace that? And then, you know, we didn't know that number 41, Jonah Todd, would be second in the SEC in hitting and do such a good job, but he did so well that he went in the sixth round and bounced out of the program. So we feel like Jay's that next guy. Judd Ward, freshman from Russellville. We think Jeremy Johnson can play that role as well, but fairly interchangeable. Steven Williams, we don't have the dual pitcher position player, but we've got a lot of dual defensive positions. Steven Williams, catcher to right field. Edward Julian is another left-handed bat that's a freshman swinging it well. He's a second base right fielder. And then left fielder, we have put Connor Davis. We have not played him at first base. Estes and Connor Davis have went to that outfield and played it every day. And I didn't know if it was going to happen or not in the fall. In the last couple of weeks, I'm starting to really get some assurance and feeling good that Connor Davis has grown as an outfielder and is playing it well. So I think he'll get some sincere opportunities, probably opening day in left field to do that. It allows us to get another bat in the lineup, which excites me. And, you know, I know I'm probably leaving a guy or two out. Bowen McGuffin, a senior, is just steady. He checks so many boxes. Just that's a player you can trust. So he'll play a lot and get a lot of opportunities. But that's kind of a scan around the field of what I expect, kind of too deep.
Do you think your lineup, top to bottom, has more production, more power this season or less?
You never know when you play each other. We have more depth, more guys can play, and we think – I'm not going to put a guy – I don't think any coach is going to put a guy in a game or in a lineup if you don't think they're going to be able to help you win. I don't – or have success or the team function properly. So I think we're much deeper. I thought last year we were thin and ready, and this year I think we got to continue to get better. But I think this team has an opportunity to grow. I think we need to go see where we're at. But it is a deeper. It has more power. Steven Williams and Edward Julian, I hope they're ready to go. They're going to get an opportunity. But they both have real power, and they're real talented, and they're going to be real good. You know, I'm just really interested, is it now? And how much can they help us now? Connor Davis, I think, is really connected great with Coach Gross, Coach Nunnemaker. And through the fall, when you made a mistake, instead of like thinking last year, man, Connor's really going to develop and have some power. You know, he lost baseballs when pitches were thrown at him and they missed location. So Dylan Lettison home runs last year. And you know, I'm seeing the same power that he had last year in leading the team, but I'm seeing him backside, driving balls, splitting gaps. Josh Anthony, I think, is so much more capable of having more and doing more. So I think our lineup's a lot stronger, beefier. I think if you come out and hadn't seen us this year and you just look at us on the field, I think we look bigger and more physical. I see that in the lineup, and then I need Will Holland to keep being athletic and, you know, let his eyes move his feet. Attack some base running. I think Luke Jarvis and Jay Estes, I'd love for them to be able to hit one and two in our lineup, Jarvis being the leadoff. In another year, them having a second year in our program, I'm so interested in a two-strike approach. Can they be more competitive in the two-strike approach? And hopefully all these SEC at-bats last year allow you to say yes. Because if we can hit them one and two and they can be really competitive with two strikes, I think there's a lot of depth and length and a big bump from where we were last year offensively, and I think our offense can become a huge part of our game.
Dylan, how different is it? It's a lot of second-year guys, you and Luke, Jay, Josh, like second-year but seniors. How different is it going into this year than last year because of what you know?
I would say it's a lot different just like in the comfort level. Like We've all played a whole lot of baseball games together. Last year, you know, you're going in unknown. Nobody knows, like, what's going to happen throughout the year, and you still don't know that this year, but, you know, we have a good idea of how the season goes, how long it is, how much of a grind it is. And really, we're just ready. Just ready to go out there and compete every day. You know, everybody's going to try to stay healthy, and we're just going to compete every day and try to drive in as many runs as we can.
Yeah, I'm definitely excited about it, but it's, you know, replacing Keegan Thompson is, you know, a very tall task to do. And I don't expect to go be Keegan Thompson. I want to be myself, but, you know, he had a lot of traits and a lot of characteristics that I would love to kind of resemble that he did because, you know, like I said then, he really laid a good foundation for the weekend. And he kind of showed me and some other pitchers, you know, how to really attack hitters. He showed us that staying in the zone wins you games. So just being able to do that for, you know, some of the younger guys or some of the other starters is going to be pretty big and pretty pivotal for our program. And so I know that's a pretty tall challenge for me, but, you know, I feel like we've prepared well enough that, you know, I'm kind of ready to step in that and give it the best I got.
There's a number of guys that have allowed the junior year to affect them because of their draft status. Obviously, I've had scouts say to me that he could be the number one overall pick. How have you tried to, like, block that out?
Yeah, you know, people ask me a lot, is any of this stuff affecting you? And it's not, man. It's just, I just got to keep it team mentality. You know, I think I do a pretty good job of that because that's way up on my priority list over, you know, something that's uncontrollable, honestly. And, you know, how I interact with my teammates and how I perform for my team is definitely controllable. So I just need to master that and do a pretty good job of that. And, you know, the draft and, you know, my future after Auburn is going to play out how it is. But while I'm here, I'm gonna give Auburn everything I got and this baseball team everything I got because they've earned that. You know, I love my teammates and I wouldn't want to take a moment away of me being selfish away from them because they don't really deserve that. So I don't think it's gonna affect my play. I'm just gonna go out and do the same thing that I've done my whole life and try to throw strikes and get out. So I'm not gonna try to, you know, impress anybody other than my teammates really.
I'm just tickled to death at his maturity, how much he's grown since we first played our first game together and him starting his freshman year. You know, and he did. Keegan invested in Casey so much, and they're throwing partners. You know, every day they would throw together, and they just grew together. And, you know, players leave legacies. And to this point, and once we get going through a season, what I say to this point is there'll be challenges this year. We're playing the best league in America, and we got to be there for one another and pick him up. And every coach and every ball player and everybody on our support staff is going to do everything in our power for him to aim as high as he possibly can. But Casey knows the best way to do that is to serve his club, and everything will happen for him. But now I see Casey investing in Davis Daniel. I see Casey teaching our players. Casey's already a success this year. Casey's invested in each one of our pitchers on our pitching staff as much or more than any player I've ever seen. So the success that we're going to have, he's already prepared. It's not just the lights come on this Friday. He's already made an unbelievable impact in our program. And I think Keegan did a good job of teaching that. Now that'll be Casey's legacy, not just being a great pitcher, but now he teaches whoever's left next year, and with these freshmen, and whether Davis, you know, leaves or comes back, that just continues to pass down. I want to see Davis Daniel improve from freshman to sophomore year like Casey did. That's how great programs supposed to work, step by step by step, and whenever there's a gap, somebody steps in and picks it up. But I couldn't be more proud of this young man, whether he goes 16-0 or whether he's 500 or anywhere in between, because I see it every day. Everybody else is going to start seeing what they see starting this week, but I already know the investment he's made in our program and in his teammates, and it's pretty powerful.
The pitching staff, does that have the potential to be a little deeper in quality arms this year? If it is, what kind of big deal is that for teams over
Well, I think, you know, we're trying to aim as high as we possibly can, and I can't make any bones about it. I think it's neat when the players have a dream, and I want to support that dream. So we had our players. We just had our banquet with Tom Glavine and Tim Hudson, which was just beautiful over here in the practice facility last Saturday night. And those players are the ones walking up there, and as they announce a team goal, they're the ones saying Omaha. And I thought when I first got here, you know, we're kind of – of course you dream of something. You have a vision of going to Omaha and playing for a national championship. That's why we signed up. But it seemed more like a pipe dream. And now, as heartbreaking as it was not to acquire one more positive pitch in a regional last year, I do believe that vision changed from a pipe dream to something tangible, and we can see it and taste it and feel it and believe in it. Because I think we were that close from being in Omaha last year. That's what I believe. But when these guys are up there on that podium last Saturday night, see, that was a huge exercise for me as their head coach. Is, you know, I want to lead them to their dreams the best of my ability. And now having these guys say that, and it's not coming from me, is powerful. But we have to be deeper. And we led this league for 7 weeks last year, 7 SEC weekends. We were coming out of that thing in first place. And some fatigue, you know. These guys run out as hard as they could. They played as hard as they could. And we kind of all got banged up and a little tired at the same time. So there's no doubt that, you know, having the least amount of scholarships and the least amount of things is something that we have to overcome. We have to be small market minded, basically, to figure it out. But we do have more depth, and that's supposed to pay huge dividends. Maybe Luke Jarvis doesn't have to play every day if, you know, Edward Julian can spell him. Maybe he doesn't have to throw to get to the back end of the game of the 7th, 8th inning, or throw a complete game just to keep us in the hunt. So we'll do everything in our power to develop as much depth. We bought into pitching, dominate the routine play, and timely hitting when we got here. Now we feel like we have more pitching depth. And we're going to have to let them sink or swim to try to develop that. So when we lock in, that's what I meant. This team's different. This team has a chance to get better every time the calendar flips because of that depth. And but we'll unveil it. Seemed like last year we were like, this is our team. This is who we are. And those guys, I've never had a team probably in 25 years fight as hard as last year's team. If you didn't cover it really closely, you don't realize that last year's team, man for man, played hurt, played as hard, played as consistent as any team. I've never been more proud of a baseball team than our Auburn baseball team last year. And hopefully a couple layers of depth is the difference, will make the difference for us this year.
Dylan, what do you think about some of the players, specifically Stephen Williams and Edward Julian?
Just those two guys specifically, just really impressed, you know. I started my freshman year at Mississippi State with Coach Thompson, and I wasn't nearly as advanced as a baseball player as they are. So just seeing that, being a fifth-year senior and seeing these guys come in as freshmen and just seeing how advanced they are, you know, hitting-wise, really. And it's just kind of mind-blowing. And I can't even imagine how good they're going to be next year and the year after that. But this year I really see them being able to help us a lot, playing right field, catching, second base, whatever they're going to be doing. But you know, just really excited about those guys and can't wait to see where they go.
Casey, have you seen Davis Daniels step up a little bit so far? What do you think about the two freshmen, Tanner and Gilman?
Yeah, Davis, I've seen him grow a little bit. I think he knew he needed to learn some stuff and, you know, kind of make that jump. And I think he's done a really good job with it. You know, he's kind of been really focused and been really deliberate with every pitch. And, you know, he's trying to get better. And, you know, he has gotten better. And, yeah, I think he's going to be really good for us. Yeah, Tanner and Cody, you know, they're pretty fun to watch. Those guys have high energy. They play fast pace. You know, they want the ball. You know, Cody, we call her Bull, because he looks really mean up there. He wants the ball. Give it back to me. I'm going to throw a fastball by you. And, you know, we love that mentality for him. You can tell, like, even when we're scrimmage is more low energy. You know, we try to make them not, but they are. But when he gets on the mound, the energy just, you know, skyrockets up. So, I mean, we love that about him. Tanner's so advanced. You know, his stuff is like Dylan said, when he was a freshman. I'm kind of in the same boat with Tanner, because Tanner was really advanced from what I was. That guy's got really good stuff, and he's pretty electric. And you know, what I like about Tanner is he's trying new things and he really wants to learn. You know, I really like that about him. He doesn't act like he has it figured out at all. And so I really like that he wants to learn new things and try new things, and I think that's really going to help him this year and down the road. And so I think those two guys and Davis are really going to be pivotal and, you know, give us a chance to